Mario Party 2 is a game with so many different kinds of mini-games that it's nearly impossible to have a strategy for each. Thus, we must concentrate on the bigger picture. So bow down to my slick style of systematic subversion. Lesson 1. Learn the adventure boards and learn the mini-games. Spend some time playing when your friends aren't looking. Gain the upper hand by knowing ahead of time how to avoid Bowser and match the pictures. This may seem sneaky, but think of it as a warm-up. You warm up before soccer, right? Lesson 2. Know when to spend your coins on items. Buying items works to your advantage in two ways. 1. They can help you get an edge by allowing you to steal other players' coins. And 2. By spending your coins, you keep your foe from stealing them. But it's a double-edged sword, so be careful and purchase wisely. Once you have a comfortable lead, buy a mushroom to get to the end of the board quickly. The shrooms allow you to double or triple your rolls. And since we all know that getting stars is the real way to succeed, try getting the magic lamp. There are other items. Learn what each does and use them wisely. Okay, so now you practice the mini-games and know what each item does. The next lesson is more about the psychological side of Mario Party 2. Okay, this won't work playing against the computer, but it will absolutely work against your friends. Having a large lead is mentally debilitating to your real-life opponents. If you have a huge lead, do what you can to keep it. Don't feel like you can't continue to steal those with less coinage. Be ruthless. If you find yourself down a few coins, gamble. Take chances that could even put you in greater debt. Why? You have nothing to lose. Also, steal from the rich and keep it. There's nothing more difficult for the person in the lead to have to come to terms with than the fourth-place player to come back from a huge deficit. Finally, don't be afraid to talk smack to the other players. By taunting them while they play mini-games, you can distract them from the very task that keeps them in the lead. Specific comments about the player's mother generally work, though in most cases, simply screaming and yelling can be enough for them to lose concentration. Remember, subverting the dominant Mario paradigm seems tough, but with a little practice and some well-timed dishes, you can guarantee a win. Oh, and one other thing. When rolling, wait about 4 seconds, then stop the die. It will nearly always get you a 10.